गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल, वेलकम बैक टू योर ऑनलाइन लेक्चर ऑफ एनवायरमेंट सब्जेक्ट। हाउ आर यू गाइड्स? ऑफकोर्स यू आर फाइन एट योर होम एंड आई विश यू आर सेफ एट योर होम। सो आर यू एंजॉइंग दिस ऑनलाइन लेक्चर्स? यस, I'm sure you must be enjoying these lectures because nobody is there to look at you, whether you are really doing it or not study. Am I right? But still, you are missing our college 101%. Okay, let's start today's lecture. Before moving further, let's recall what we learned in the last lecture. In last lecture, we have seen unit 2. We have started with unit 2, that is energy resources. And tell me what we have learned in the last lecture. We learned about natural resources. Which are the natural resources? Water, mineral, food, soil and land, forest, and one more. Anyone remember? Okay, so overall we have learned about 6 resources and we have started looking why these resources are depleting. Am I right? And last time we have seen a depletion of water and depletion of soil. Okay, so let's start today's lecture, continuing unit 2, energy resources. Now, the next point is depletion of mineral resources. What are minerals? As I previously told, minerals we get from earth crust. They are very much valuable and they are crystalline in nature. Yes, as we know that minerals are non-renewable resources. They are non-renewable. Means we don't get again and again. How do we get minerals? These are obtained by mining and by metallurgical processes. Everyone knows this. Okay, we get minerals in earth's crust in impure form. Okay, by mining we obtain the minerals, but in impure form, like diamond is in black in color when it is in impure form. After metallurgical process we get it in pure form. Yes, mining pollutes the environment on a large scale. Okay, to find a mineral, definitely I have to dig somewhere on land. Digging means I am disturbing the environment. So, to get a large number of minerals, I have to dig entire land. Then only I will find, and not only entire land, I have to dig under and under earth crust, then only I'll get these minerals. The rate at which we are digging these minerals, our future generation may face the extinction. Okay, we are using however we want, so definitely future generation will get less of it. Now, as the population is more and more, the demand is also more, so definitely supply will be less. So as a result, the prices will be high and high, and they can be buy only by rich people. They are not available easily for the poor people. The best example for this, gold and petrol. I mentioned these two only because nowadays everyone knows that gold prices is more than 40,000. Yes, for 1 tola of gold, we have to pay more than 40,000. Is it affordable by a poor people? And another best and daily needed example is petrol. We need petrol daily. And what are the prices of petrol? It is about 80 to 100 rupees per liter. Is it affordable by a poor people? Of course not. And we use vehicle for every work. I want to buy a milk. I'll use my Activa. I want to just go to temple. I'll use my bike. So lots of petrol we need. Even youngsters, those who are in 8, 9, 10 standard, they are also using vehicles. So definitely we need a huge amount of petrol. So price will be definitely high. And as the demand is more, we need more and more petrol. For that, we have to request Iraq or Iran, please give us more petrol, more diesel. So for supply of petrol and diesel, they have to dig more and more. So like this, depletion of mineral resources is happening. Now, what are the causes of depletion of mineral resources? The first cause is definitely increased demand. And has this demand and economy, both are correlated. Economy based on fossil fuels like coal, petrol and diesel, minerals and oil. See, India is depend on Iraq and Iran for petrol, diesel. Am I right? See, my GK is not so good, but still, I know something. So, our country's economy is based on import and export. Our import of petrol is too much high. So, whose economy is best? Iraq and Iran. So they have to dig more and more to complete each and everyone's demand of petrol. This is the first point of depletion of mineral resources. Second, lots of building materials are obtained from mines like stone, marbles, granite, limestone. So that's why. Nowadays, you know, each and everyone, even four people are living in a big bungalows. They want their bungalows to look very high class. For that, they need different marbles to decorate their house. They need different styles, variety of stones to decorate it again, their bungalow. So, demand has increased. So, they have to again dig more and more. This is the second reason. And the last one more important reason is to support 8 to 9% of GDP growth of any country. Mining sector has to do well. It puts extra effort on mineral. See, the Iraq exports petrol. So definitely, to grow their income, they have to export more and more petrol. So they are focusing on that area. Minerals area. So that's why they start digging everywhere, searching minerals everywhere in their country. So like this, it disturbs environment. Now, what are the effects of this? Resulted in more drilling and searching for other territories enriched with minerals. So definitely the country who are the exporters of these minerals, definitely they have to look where I'll get minerals, in which land the minerals are more and more. I don't know whether it is 100% true or not. I heard a recent matter about Ladakh, that is India and China. I heard where this फाइटिंग वॉज हैपन बिटवीन इंडियंस एंड चाइनीज सोल्जर्स. आई हर्ड दैट लैंड ऑफ लद्दाख इज फुल्ली एनरिच विद मिनरल्स. दैट्स वाई चाइना वॉन्ट्स इट. सो दैट्स वाई दिस इंटरनल फाइटिंग इज गोइंग ऑन. सो लाइक दिस सर्चिंग फॉर अ लैंड विच इज एनरिच विद मिनरल्स लीड्स विथ फाइटिंग. Mining pollutes the environment. Even you may have seen this in films. Some people are mining something. At that time, landslides, some accidents also may occur. This is also one of the side effect of mining. That sometimes accidents may occur, landslides may occur. Next. Onshore mining processes badly affects marine life. Definitely, if mining is happening near the sea area, definitely it will affect on marine life. Next point, situation becomes grim when local people are denied of their share in development process. Example of this is if someone comes to know this land is fully enriched with minerals, then government start gives us this land, and suppose this land belongs to me, I'm the owner of that land. Then suppose I reject it, I'm not going to give you my land. Do whatever you want. So definitely, there will be a fight. There will be a worse situation between I and government. So such things also happens because of this minerals. So how to prevent this depletion of mineral? First point, government needs to show more strong political will to preserve our resources. See, as we are very habituated with this comfortable life, definitely we need all the things. I need comfortable life, I want vehicles because I can't walk, I want air condition because I can't live in a hot climate. Yes, of course we want this comfortable life, but as well as we have to show interest in saving our environment. And government can't do everything. We have to show our interest individually. Not only interest, this is our responsibility to save our environment. This is individual's responsibility. Am I right? Use of synthetic building materials can reduce the load on natural stones. Okay, instead of stones only or instead of anything natural material, we can use synthetic materials, man-made materials to decorate our home, to decorate everything. Use of new technologies at thermal power plants, metallurgy, so that great outputs can be obtained from less inputs. Try to invoke new technology which will give you more benefits on less inputs. Try to find out now. Next point is depletion of forest resources. We know the word deforestation. Deforestation means clearing the forest. Why do we clear the forest? Of course, for our benefit only. Hey, who cares about the environment? Who cares about the animals, those who are living in that forest? It's their life. Let them do whatever they want. Let them go wherever they want. I need a land, so I will clear the forest. Who will stop me? Yes, this is the attitude of our human beings. So, as a result, presently about half of the forests that once covered the earth have been destroyed because of this our attitude. I need, so I will clear the forest. This is our attitude. Because of this attitude, now the earth is completely open. There are very less forests left. Now, what are the causes? Why I need land for my purpose? Definitely first one is for agriculture reason. To give food to this much population, I need more and more farming. For this I need land. Again, for this I have to cut the forest. For development of industry, school and colleges. Yes, I am Ambani. I want to establish 3-4 industries. Oh, clear this forest. Yeah, just clear the forest. See, for industries, building school and colleges, people are clearing the forest. For developing residential area also, people are clearing the forest. The best example for this residential area, I'm talking about residential area, the best example is Pune. As everyone is moving towards Pune, Pune has spread too much. Actual Pune is totally different. Katrads, Kothrud, so much it is spread. So that's why there is no forest nowadays. Next example, during constructions of big dams, sizable forest land and vegetation cover gets submerged. See, sometimes we need to construct a dam. At that time, unfortunately, we have to cut the forest or we have to destroy that farm vegetation cover sometimes. Now, what are the impact of this forest depletion? The worst effect we are facing is global warming. Of course, as there is very less forest, there are very less trees, so definitely there will be a rise in percentage of carbon dioxide, so there will be rise in temperature, which leads to global warming. What is the current temperature in summer? It's more than 45 degrees somewhere. Face it, these are your deeds only. Second, change in water cycle. As there is a global warming, so there is a change in water cycle. They depend on both each other. Increased soil erosion with risk of landslide. As there are no trees, soil is freely movable. As wind comes, and definitely there is decreased biodiversity. As there are no forests, animals are moving towards residential area. We have seen on news many times, cheetah found in village, elephants found in someone's garden. So like this, we have seen number of news. As we are disturbing their houses, they will definitely come in our house. Now, how to control deforestation? Definitely the answer is reforestation. Plant more and more trees. United Nations and the World Bank have started REDD, means Reducing Emissions from Deforestation and Forest Degradation program, that works especially with developing countries to use subsidies or other incentives to encourage and educate citizens to use the forest in a more sustainable way. See, We have to encourage and educate people, small children, about environment. We have to give some incentives so they can make up their mind to plant a tree. Now, we have ended up with point one, that is natural resources and the causes and effects of depletion of these resources. Now, we have reached to the second point of this unit, second, renewable, non-renewable and cyclic resources. Let's see what are these. Can you see here a table with heading renewable resources? You tell me, what are renewable resources? Renewable resources are which we can get it again and again, and they are definitely free of cost. So let's see what are they. Example, first example is of solar energy. Second, it is from where we get, and its third column is of use. So first one is solar energy. Of course, we get it from sun in form of electromagnetic radiations. And what are its use? For domestic and industrial use. Domestic use is like nowadays we are using solar heater for heating the water and solar cooker instead of pressure cooker. Second, hydropower. It sources water and its use is, of course, to generate electricity. Next is wind power. Its source is, of course, as name suggests, its source is air. Again, its use, of course, to generate electricity. Next one is tidal power. Its source is rise and fall of tidal water. Again, its use is to generate electricity. See, as I have said, electricity. So from that you can understand how much electricity is important for us. So that's why the demand is more for electricity. We have to think about its production of electricity, which gives us more and more production. Next is geothermal power. Its source is rocks beneath the earth's surface. Again, its use is to generate electricity. Next one is nuclear fuels. From where we get it? Fusion reactions of radioactive elements, we get nuclear power. And its use is nuclear power generation. Now, what are the importance of renewable sources of energy? The first main reason to use these renewable sources is they do not pollute. They don't cause pollution. Second, these are renewable and present in nature in abundant quantity. See, they are present in nature in a large amount of quantity. They are not shortage. They are available free of cost from nature. See, sun doesn't say, hey, pay me some bill. I'm giving you energy. Come on, pay me some bill. Its sun say this to us? Of course not. Sun is spreading his energy free of cost. These are sustainable. Okay, can sun will die? No, nah. So they are sustainable for long years. So use, yeah, it is free of cost and it is for long period of time. Now, let's see non-renewable resources. As the name suggests, once they finish, we can't get it back. Am I right? They are also known as conventional sources. Due to increasing population, all resources fall in short. To meet this shortage, renewable energy sources are required to be used more and more. So, those who are non-renewable resources, please use them less. And those are renewable sources, please increase their uses. So which are the non-renewable resources? Wood, coal, crude oil, etc. These are non-renewable resources. See, we can get these non-renewable resources, of course, but it takes 100 of years to generate it again. Now, you have heard about renewable and non-renewable resources, but you didn't heard about cyclic energy resources. So, cyclic energy resources means some natural resources are cyclically reused. Example, water cycle. See, water is a cyclic energy resources. You know water life cycle? No need to explain that. So, that comes under cyclic energy resources. Once we use, again we can get it back. So, that is called as cyclic energy resources. So, this is for today's lecture. Let's recall what we have learned in this lecture. We have seen depletion of mineral resources, its causes and its effects. Then we have seen depletion of forest resources, its causes and effects. Then we learn about renewable and non-renewable resources and cyclic resources also. Guys, I feel as you are studying this environment subject, please plant at least one tree or take care of it at least. See, if you have already plants at your house, just take care of it. And whatever petrol you are using, I know right now you are using bikes. So, use if you are going for a long distance. Don't use if your distance is too short. Just walk it. Walking is good for health as well as. So save petrol for your future generation, not for us, not for you, for save your future generation. Okay, so please, I request you save environment. You know, as I'm teaching this subject, I am also feeling that at least I can take care of a plant which is already I am having in my garden. I can take care of them, yeah, and I'll start walking whenever it is possible. Thank you and have a nice day, guys.